the fall semester of my very first year here, Rich had brought a research methods class to the refuge. They were studying the concentration of a couple different invasive species across a couple different study plots in the area. And where we're standing right now was where that class had done some of its transects. And what they found was that we had a significantly higher infestation of multiflora rose than anywhere else they looked at.
My name is Brian Capron. I'm the biotech intern here at the Erie National Wildlife Refuge. I'm part of the Allegheny Class of 2019. One of the recommendations we gave was for goats.
We work as a team with the students. They are research partners. Granted, we have more experience than they do, but they can come up with terrific ideas, and that's the creative element of science. Unlike maybe that high school experiment where there's steps 1 through 20, you follow those, you get an answer, we don't have a list of steps. As faculty members, we have some ideas on how things might go, best ways to go, but we want students to both experience it, but also to learn it. And the best way to learn it is to struggle yourself with coming up with those sets of criteria on how you're going to address things.
Kind of just one of those things that, to me, it just sort of seemed like, okay, yeah, it's interesting and everything, but is it actually going to be used? And the fact that here it is being put into practice out here in the very spot where we were doing our survey is an extremely rewarding experience for me. That's the best, when the most efficient method also happens to be the most environmentally friendly. Yeah, that's pretty fantastic. And it doesn't seem to happen as often as most of us would like. Alternative would pretty much be to have a team of people out here with chemical backpacks and spend several weeks coming back and forth just dousing all of these plants, like you probably do a cut stump sort of thing, where you would have one person cut the plant, the other person would come in with the backpack and douse it with herbicides, which would work. It would kill the plant, and it would kill it the first time through. The big issue in this particular spot, though, is that we have a couple of streams running through, and the sheer amount of herbicides that would be necessary for this entire area would not be good for the waterways. Gavin, who owns the goat herd, each of his goat teams comes with a guard donkey.
She's a character. She has a different mood every day. Sometimes Brian is not allowed to get close to put on the fly spray. She'll only let me come over.
It's my job pretty much to come out here every morning, do a head count, of course, make sure Diamond's all right, and just keep tabs on them, basically. And I get to see their antics all throughout the summer. And yeah, they're just a joy to work around. It's always fun having the opportunity to work around animals.